Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to our Arabic class. We are doing the Medina Arabic course book 1, and we are currently on page 97. Last week we had begun lesson number 17, and I had mentioned that for this week will be your homework would be to give the answers for exercise number 1. So for those who actually have the answers, you are welcome to send in, as you can see over here. Okay, let's begin. Bismillah walhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. So we were doing the tamarin, the exercises, and number one was ajiba anil as'ilati al-atiyati. Answer the following questions. So there are 10 questions given over here. The question is given in Arabic. You need to give the answer in Arabic. And what I mentioned was that all of these questions were things that we had done previously. So you have all the tools at your disposal to be able to give the answers. So you could use the answers given in the course of the book. You could give your own answer from your own side. You want to use the book's vocab, it's your choice. You want to use your own vocab, it's fine too. But just be able to answer the questions. And that was your homework for today. So if anybody has done the homework, or if you happen to know the answers, then you are welcome to send it in right now. So let me do number one, just so you can see. Number one is, Ain al-kutubul jadidatu? Ain al-kutubul jadidatu? Then you would reply whatever you want to say. For example, al-kutubul jadidatu ala tawilati. The new book, where are the new books? The new books are on the table. Al-kutubu al-jadidatu fi sayyarati. The new books are in the car, whatever the case you want to go with. So anybody want to take a try at number two? Liman hadhihi al-buyutu al-kabiratu? Who do these big houses belong to? Anybody want to take a try at giving the answer for this? No takers? All right. Let me do number two. Number two, liman hadhihi al-buyutu al-kabiratu? To who does these big houses belong to? Hadhihi al-buyutu al-kabiratu? Hadhihi. Remember here what I'm saying. Hadhihi al-buyutu al-kabiratu lit-tabibi. These big houses belong to the doctor. Number three, abwabu sayyarati maftuhatun? Are the doors of the car open? أبواب السيارة مفتوحة. Are the doors of the car open? Then you can say نعم هي مفتوحة. نعم هي مفتوحة. If you're not understanding anything, what I'm saying right now, it means you are too far behind. You need to go back and listen to the previous classes. If you are able to understand, well and good. Then let's move on. So نعم هي مفتوحة. Yes, they are open. Number four, أين أقلام المدرس؟ أين أقلام المدرس؟ Where are the teacher's pens? أقلام المدرس في حقيبته. For example, the teacher's pens are in his briefcase. أين الكلاب؟ Where are the dogs? الكلاب في الشارع. For example, the dogs are in the street. أين الحمير؟ Where is the donkey? Okay, you can say الحمير في البيت. You have some donkeys. So where is the donkey? The donkey is in the house. Number seven. أين كتبك يا مريم؟ أين كتب plural كتبك يا مريم؟ Where are your books, O Maryam? Where are your books, O Maryam? Kutubi fi bayti, or kutubi fi haqibati, or kutubi ala sariri, whatever you want to say. My kutubi ala sariri, my books are on my bed. Kutubi fi sayarati, my books are in my car. Kutubi fi haqibati, my books are in my briefcase, whatever the case may be that you want to go with. Number seven, aina dafatiru tullabi? Aina dafatiru tullabi? Where are the students' notebooks? plural form, dafatiru. Aina dafatiru tullabi? Dafatiru tullabi fil fasli. Where are the students' notebooks? The students' notebooks are in the classroom. Okay, what you are? Matbakhi means kitchen. So, hiya fil matbakhi. They, if you're using it in the correct manner, they are in the kitchen. Fine, no problem with it. Okay, so that is number 8. Number 9. Aina fanadiqu saghirati? أين فنادق الصغيرة؟ فنادق الصغيرة. فنادق, we did this word once upon a time. This is just a plural form. The blue, it's a plural for the word funduq. Funduq al-kaki. So funduq means a hotel. فنادق is the plural form. فنادق الصغيرة. Where are the small hotels? We are the small hotels because you're not looking for Hilton Hotel and the big ones over there. I'm looking for some cheap three-star little bed and breakfast or self-catering type one. I'm not looking for those seven-star hotels. So give me one of the small ones. We are the small hotels. Then you could say here, once again, if you want to use it that way, or you can use the word itself. So you can say here fi hadha shari'i. For example, they are in this road. Those small hotels are in this road. Perfectly fine. Or you can say, Al-fanadiqu saghiratu fi hadhihi shari'i, fi hadha shari'i. The small hotels are in this road. In Arabic, in English also, you can say, where are the cars? The cars are here. Or you can say, they are here. So Arabic and English, both you can use it in the same manner. Whether you want to mention the thing you are speaking about or not, that's entirely your choice, up to you, what you decide. So, like I say, it's your choice at the end of the day. Both ways are perfectly fine. Number 10. لِمَنْ هَذِهِ الْأَقْلَامُ الْجَدِيدَةُ To whom do these new pens belong? Who is the owner of these new pens in simple terms? So هذه الأقلام الجديدة لبنت الفلاح. These new pens belong to the farmer's daughter. That's the end of that exercise. Let's move on to the next exercise. Exercise number 2. حول المبتدأ في كل من الجمل الآتية إلى جمع. Change the من الجمل الآتية إلى جمع. Change the مبتدأ in each of the following sentences from a singular form to a plural form. So, مثال, example, الباب مفتوح, the door is open. الأبواب مفتوحة, the doors are open. باب, أبواب, مفتوح, مفتوحة, because of being غير عاقل. Like I say, class on غير عاقل has been uploaded on YouTube already. So, if you are unsure of how it works, that's your class to go back to, the غير عاقل plurals, which has been the last 2-3 classes that we've done, at least I should say. Okay, an answer was given over here. Ha'ulai aklamu jududun. That answer is incorrect. It's not in keeping with the rules of غير عاقل. Which is why I had mentioned the issue of following up with the what exactly are غير عاقل. That's specifically the reason why I mentioned that point. Because all of this is testing you on your understanding of غير عاقل. So, الباب مفتوح, الأبواب مفتوحة. See how it changes. هذا قلم جديد, هذه أقلام جدد. هذه Aqlamun jududun. These are new pens. Not ha'ulai. They are not human beings. Hadihi aqlamun jududun. These are new pens. An-najmu jamilun. An-nujumu jamilatun. An-nujumu jamilatun. The stars are beautiful. Dhalika kitabun qadimun. Dhalika kitabun qadimun. That is an old book. Tilka kutubun qadimatun. Tilka kutubun qadimatun. Those are old books. Dhalika albaytu jamilun. Tilka albuyutu jamilatun. Number five. هذا الدرس سهل. هذه الدروس سهلة. These classes are easy. Number six. ذلك الجبل بعيد. ذلك الجبل بعيد. That mountain is far. تلك الجبال بعيدة. تلك الجبال بعيدة. Feminine, feminine. Both are changed because this is غير عاقل. So those mountains are far away. Okay, carries on. Next page, page 98. Number seven. هذا المكتب مكسور. This desk is broken. هذه المكاتب مكسورة. هذه المكاتب مكسورة. These desks are broken. Then the next one is هذا مسجد جميل. هذا مسجد جميل. هذه مساجد جميلة. هذه مساجد جميلة. These are beautiful masajid. هذه ساعة رخيصة. This is a cheap watch. هذه ساعات رخيصة. هذه ساعات رخيصة. These are cheap watches. So in reality, because we were speaking about a feminine thing, which was singular, so therefore rakhisatun was singular feminine in the first place. So the only thing which actually changed was sa'atun, which became sa'atun. So هذه sa'atun rakhisatun, هذه sa'atun rakhisatun. Singular to plural, nothing has actually changed. You really only see the change when you are dealing with masculine words. Okay, moving on. Number 10. Tilka ta'iratu kabiratun. Tilka ta'iratu kabiratun. That plane, that aeroplane is big. So, tilka ta'iratu kabiratun. Tilka ta'iratu kabiratun. Oh, wait, I'm just thinking back right now. I made a mistake over here in number one. Hadha qalamun jadidun. I think I said, hadhihi aqlamun jududun. And if that was the case, then it should be هذه أقلام جديدة. أقلام جديدة rather than جدود. I think at least that I made that mistake earlier. Anyway, coming back to where we were right now. تلك الطائرات كبيرة. Those aeroplanes are big. Number 11. هذا طالب جديد. هؤلاء هؤلاء طلاب جدد. Correct. That's the right answer. هؤلاء طلاب جدد. Because they are عاقل. We're talking about human beings over here. So هؤلاء طلاب جدد. These are new students. Number 12. ذلك الرجل عالم كبير. ذلك الرجل عالم كبير. That man is a big عالم. So أولئك الرجال. هذا we become for example هؤلاء ذلك becomes أولئك. So أولئك الرجال علماء كبار. أولئك الرجال علماء كبار. Those men are big علماء. Number 13. هذا النهر كبير. هذا النهر. النهر means the river. This river is big. So هذه الأنهار كبيرة. These rivers are big. Let's see. Yeah, maybe we can even finish the class of this lesson of at least tonight. So number three, ضعف الأماكن الخالية فيما يلي أخبارا مناسبة. So it says placing the following blank spaces over here an appropriate خبر. You have your مبتدأ and your خبر. I don't know the exact English terms now. It's not exactly predicate and object and though, you know, but basically those sort of things. So to give, for example, let's say albaytu jamilun. For example, albaytu jamilun. The house is beautiful. An-nujumu ba'idatun. Oh, albaytu. Yeah, jamilun. You can say it fine. Qareebun, whatever. So that's how that one goes. An-nujumu ba'idatun or qareebatun, whatever way you want to say it. But plural, so feminine. Jama' ghayra aqil, so it's got to correspond with a feminine word. So an-nujumu ba'idatun, the stars are far away. Al-babu mughlaqun, the door is locked. Al-qalamu maksurun, the pen is broken. Al-buyutu jamilatun, plural form, so singular feminine. Al-buyutu jamilatun. Al-abwabu maftuhatun, the doors are open. As-sayyaratu qareebatun, the cars are nearby. Al-mindilu wasikhun, the handkerchief is dirty. Al-fanadiqu kabiratun, the hotels are big. Al-tullabu jududun, the students are new. Al-qumsanu nadhifatun. Qumsan is the plural of the word qamisun, which means now a kurta, a qamis, a shirt, whichever way you want to translate it. So al-qumsanu is the plural form. Al-qumsanu nadhifatun, the kurtas are clean. And yeah, last exercise number four. He says, "Hati jam'u al-kalimati al-atiyata." Bring forth the plural forms of the following words. So, babun. Okay, here's a simple exercise for you. Just give the plural forms of these words. So, I'll do the first one, and then you can do the rest. Babun, plural form is abwabun. Baytun is singular. What's the plural form? Buyutun, correct. Najmun, what's the plural form of Najmun? Nujumun, very good. Qalamun, plural form? Aqlamun, good. Next one, Himarun, plural form? Okay, Homorun, good. Homorun or Hamirun, it's got two plurals, so you could take any one of them. But yes, that's good. Next one is Sarirun. Plural form of that one? Sarirun. Okay, we were doing actually sarirun. Sarirun is sururun. Nahrun, plural of nahrun. Plural is anharun. And sayaratun, plural is sayaratun. So that's the end of page 98. And the exercise continues onto the next page. Next few words. Kalbun, plural is kilabun. Ta'iratun, plural is ta'iratun. Darsun, plural is durusun. Bahrun, plural is biharun. Okay, kalbun meaning dog, kilabun meaning dogs. Ta'iratun meaning aeroplanes. Durusun meaning lessons, classes. Buhurun, Bahrun, singular, meaning an ocean. Buhurun, meaning oceans. Kitabun becomes kutubun. Qamisun becomes kumsanun, shirts. Darajatun becomes darajatun. Haqlun becomes hukulun. Haql means a field. Hukul means fields. Jabalun becomes jibalun. Mountain becomes mountains. And last thing for the day, or for the night at least, I should say, al-kalimatul jadidatu, the new words. Al-sharikatu, jam'u sharikatun. Al-sharikatu means the company. Jim here is an abbreviation meaning plural, which stands for jam'un, plural form meaning being sharikatun. Sharikatun, sharikatun. The company, companies. Mudiru sharikati, the CEO, as people would say in English, the head of the company. Rakhisun, which means cheap. Al-qamisu, qamisu, the shirt. Jam'u, plural form is qumsanun. Qumsanun is plural of qamisun. Shirt and shirts. And that's the end of page 99, the end of lesson number 17, and the end of our lesson for tonight, inshallah ta'ala. Next week, we will begin page 100, lesson number 18 of the Medina Arabic course, book 1. But until then, so at least for next week, you don't exactly have any homework. But what I will say your homework is to go over the previous lessons so that you are up to date and up to scratch. Because if we start a new lesson, new things will be brought in, so you need to be able to adjust to what is being taught new and not still be caught up on what has been taught by previously already. So with that being said, we end on this point here for tonight, inshallah ta'ala. Until next time, we end and we say, wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad, subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.